We've got Kamal Baheti, who's joining us right now to discuss the quarterly numbers. Sales were up 12%, profitability grew by another 11% to come at 223 crore rupees. Mcleod Russel fairly flat on today's session, 255 is where it's trading at. Mr. Baheti, thanks very much for joining in. Let's start off with the quarter gone by, and this time around, 11% growth in profitability. Are you happy? What are the factors, which factors have contributed this time around?
In fact, in this quarter, there had been two major factors which has contributed to the profitability. One, of course, had been the higher production. We were higher by around 4.5 million, 5 million kg as compared to last year in this quarter because of very good weather which has been there in Assam. And secondly, the prices of tea, particularly on exports, had been higher as compared to last year. Overall prices for the quarter were higher by around 5 rupee a kg. So these two factors had actually contributed to the profitability.
What have been realizations during the quarter, and what do you expect them to be over the next few quarters?
No, in fact, the realization during this quarter had been around 156 rupees per kg against 151 rupees kg, per kg last year in the same quarter. Currently in India, the prices are a little soft, basically on the backdrop of very strong production out of Assam. But export prices continue to be very good. There had been shortage in crop in Kenya and other African countries, and that has actually brought in the demand. Plus, rupee depreciation is also helping in the export realization. So I would say currently the prices are similar to what it is there last year, if I look at on an average. But on a cumulative basis, we continue to be around 5-6 rupees higher than last year.
Sure. Let's talk about the overseas subsidiary and their performance this quarter.
In fact, every subsidiary has done better than last year, particularly on prices. Ugandan, the prices are higher by around 20 cents as per kg as compared to last year. There had been a little drop in production in Uganda, but that has been more or less compensated by the increased prices. On Vietnam, the prices are higher and the crop is higher by 500,000 kg. And the new company which is actually coming, Rwanda, that has been a big contributor, even if it is a small volume of 2 million kg. But the margin over there is around 60-odd%. So we expect for the full year, all these subsidiaries put together should contribute around $13-14 million onto our EBITDA, into the consolidated Mcleod Russel.
Could you give us a guidance in terms of, what have you kept as your internal targets for profit as well as revenues for FY12, considering that you've clocked in about 223 crores for this quarter? Could we extrapolate that into the next few quarters as well?
In fact, third and fourth quarter seems okay. In fact, third quarter should be a little better. This quarter, we had made a provision of around 7 crore on mark-to-market for our Forex, which you booked for the third and fourth quarter exports. Naturally, that will get reversed. That was only a notional loss. Plus, export, which is actually been done, will actually be reflected in the third quarter. So we expect third and fourth quarter to be a little better than last year. But the profitability, which has been there till the second quarter, I think will reflect at the end of the year as well.
Sales targets?
In fact, FY12, we should do around 81 million kg in India and around 23 million kg from overseas subsidiaries. Overall, it should be around 103-104 million kg against 95-96 million kg last year. The prices in the overseas market are expected to be higher. In India, we expect it to be around 5-7 rupees on a cumulative basis higher than last year. So I think overall, there should be around 15-20% top line growth, and we expect that kind of a growth at the bottom line as well.
Looking at acquisitions there, Mr. Baheti, and have you set aside funds for the same?
See, we would like to really grow in the countries where we are. As we made it clear earlier also that we would like to grow in Africa. There is nothing which is there for acquisitions. As far as war chest is concerned, we will be almost debt-free by the end of the year on net debt. So the internal generation is good enough to really look at any kind of an acquisition. So there is a sufficient funds available with us going forward for any kind of an acquisition. But I think it is more whether there is a availability of certain assets, the kind of assets which you are looking at for sale. But if there are opportunities, we will definitely look at acquiring them.
Sure. Could you give us a pricing outlook as well for the coming year?
Domestic prices may remain the same as the for the balance period as last year. export should be higher. So overall, for the second half, we expect the prices to maintain or be a little higher. But on a cumulative basis, we expect it to be 5 to 7 rupees higher. On international prices, I think the way the weather is there in Kenya, we expect the prices to remain strong. But more than this year, whereby we have already gone through the entire season of production in India, I think next year with this kind of a production shortfall in Kenya and Sri Lanka, and the kind of weather which has been there in this year in Assam, very difficult to repeat this kind of weather. I think outlook for the next year looks much better than the second half this year.
Mr. Baheti, pleasure chatting with you. Thank you very much for joining us with a quick take on your quarterly performance and what it's likely to shape up over the next year as well.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.